This workshop, as you are aware, is organized as part of activities marking this year's Exercise Crocodile Smile 6. As Nigerians, you may now be aware that this exercise has become routine at this time of the year. Exercise Crocodile Smile has evolved into an effective tool for confronting increasing levels of criminality and violence usually characterize the concluding part of every year. Exercise Crocodile Smile was before now traditionally conducted in the south-south and southeast zones of the country. Its remarkable success over the years informed the decision of the Chief of Army Staff to extend the exercise to other parts of the country. In one division, while we seek to foster a safe and secure environment for the Yuletide, which is central to the objective of exercise, we are also bringing into focus the menace of armed banditry and kidnapping that continue to plague us and dominate some aspects of the media. As I wish to acknowledge the relentless efforts of security agencies that have prevented and foiled countless bandit attacks and kidnap attempts, the unfortunate incidents that have slipped through our guards are at the same time lamentable. These attacks and violation of citizens' rights is therefore a call for us as stakeholders in internal security to do an introspection and re-examine our strategies. This workshop is thus one of those ways. The principal aim of this workshop, therefore, is to present us a platform to rub minds and interrogate our strategies towards comprehensively ridding our area of responsibility of criminality and violence. This workshop is therefore aptly themed Harnessing the Potentials in Interagency Collaboration. In recognition of the potency of interagency cooperation when effectively harnessed, our contemporary security threats present novel and diverse challenges that cannot be effectively addressed by any single agency or indeed any security force. Collaboration is therefore indispensable in our efforts if we seek to achieve our collective aim. All facets of society must indeed get on board actively or passively by denouncing violence, denying criminals sanctuary, and resist propagating the agenda of terrorists by unwittingly amplifying their atrocities. This also makes the media a critical component of interagency drive. It is therefore my fervent hope that we deliberate and following these interactions, refine our strategies. Gaps in our operations will be closed, resulting in a safe and secure environment for our citizens. I therefore implore you all to be frank and dispassionate in your contributions, as we also urge Nigerians and especially the media to display objectivity and demonstrate patriotism in their reportage. We all have a stake in our beloved country. For us in uniform, let me remind us that Nigerian people invest so much and place a high premium on us.
While appreciating the roles of security agencies in tackling insecurity, it is no secret that interagency rivalry has been a hindrance in efforts against banditry and insurgency. This is not peculiar to security agencies in Nigeria. It is a global challenge which usually manifests when handling and dealing with security problems, even in advanced countries. For the benefit of doubt, here is a prominent case in point. One of the most definitive security breaches in living memory is the 9/11 attack in the United States. I believe that this is the underlying psychology security agencies must work with. All units must work as one team with one fight. A lack of this collaborative spirit has made our security agencies to sometimes become liabilities instead of assets to themselves and the entire security architecture. The absence of effective cooperation has not only claimed hundreds of civilian lives, but scores of security operatives as well. From our intelligence gathering, we have discovered, and it is important for us to keep this in mind, criminals, bandits, terrorists, and threats to our security are now collaborating more. to do devastating effect. If they do, then shouldn't our security agencies do the same? Because we are more organized, we are empowered by the law to protect the sovereignty of our country. So if criminals alike can come together, team up, plan, without training, without any moral backing, without constitutional backing, so it means we also have to plan, because we have no reason to fail, because we are organized. We are a face of our nation. The future of our country rests with us. You are representatives of the entire Nigerian population. The future of this country hinges on our security agencies, because our security agencies are the symbol of our unity. Our security agencies are working for Nigerian Federation. They are not working for a section of the group. That is why I argued, or people usually argue, that the only symbol, or the most strong, or one of the most institutions that have efficacy over the unity of this country is actually the armed forces and other security agencies. Furthermore, we must realize that creating and leveraging superior knowledge in the battle space enables decision, reduces operational risks, and increases the pace, coherence, and effectiveness of responses. In Kaduna State, the government supports the state-dedicated interagency security collaboration known as Operation Yaki, comprising the three services and the police, the DSS, and the Nigeria Security and Civil Defense Corps, including the State Vigilance Service. One of the most critical factors I have come to acknowledge is collaboration. Creating a cohesive security management system rests largely on the effective collaboration between the individual elements or agencies. And I'll still come back to some of the challenges that we're facing today. One, politicization of security issues is a very big problem. Journalists, political actors, and so many people today who parade themselves as security consultants, they are creation of the media. You see them on television or newspapers arguing, telling you that, oh, this is how things should have been done, doing a lot of harm to the system. But who gives them the platform to do that? It is the media. And also the misrepresentation in the media is making collaboration between citizens and security agencies and government very difficult. We just have a recent experience. There was a problem over a week ago along the Kaduna-Abuja route. From the account of Federal Road Safety Commission, the government-owned General Hospital in Dhaka, the military and the police, two people were killed. Two people lost their lives. Even if it is one person, life matters. But a newspaper reported that 15 people were killed. And what is the source? Their source hinged on a housewife, according to the report, who lives somewhere in Akilibu. And the same housewife was able to go to Gidambusa, was able to go to Gadamalam Malam Mamam, and understood that it was four times that the bandit blocked the road, a housewife. This is the source of a newspaper or a media that is reporting what is happening.
We have challenges.
Okay.
Especially we are now in this prevailing security situation. Police alone cannot do it alone. Especially we need the support of the military. There are situations where police were overwhelmed. So we really need the support of the military and other security agencies for us to succeed. The issue of security cannot be done by only one agency.